Is Richie here? Oh, yes, it is. And I'm really having quite a terrific date. You have been in there for 15 days. In the toilet for 15 days. I mean, what can a man do by himself in the toilet for 15 days? You haven't got a magazine in there, have you? If you have, you just give it a really good wipe. And you put that magazine underneath the floorboards where I keep all my secret things. Oh, my God. It's not my special homemade one, is it? The one with Claire Short apparently giving head to Raggy Omar and taking it up the arse from Cherie Blair with a strap on. That silence means something. Right, that's it, Eddie. I'm going to break this door down and come in there. I mean it. Here I come. Oh, Christ. I think I've broken my arm.
Try turning the handle.
I'm not going to fall for that one, Eddie. Richie is here, back where he belongs, in the toilet. 15 days without the sweet smack of lavatory seat on poor Richie's bottom have come to an end. Oh, bliss. Let oceans of pleasure surround and engulf poor Richie's little arsehole right now. Where's the bog? Good grief! Where is the bog? Eddie. What in the name of Satan's fetid foreskin have you been doing to the toilet? Where is the toilet? How in God's name is a young gentleman supposed to tip his skip in a place like this? Eddie, reveal yourself.
Press the button.
What?
Press the button.
What button?
The one marked do not press.
Okay.
You stupid, stupid bastard! Stupid bastard arse! You arse! You stupid arse bastard! You stupid arse bollock bastard! Nipple wank turd! Why won't this bloody toaster work?
Eddie, oh, is that you?
No.
I'm not going to fall for that old shtick.
No, it's not me.
Oh, isn't it? Oh, I do beg your pardon. Oh. Well, excuse me, madam. Do you know where Eddie is?
What's it worth?
It is you!
Oh, shit! I followed the last hurdle.
Why have you locked in the lavatory for the last 15 days? Do you know how long it is since I last went to the lavatory?
No.
Well, I do.
What the fuck are you asking me for, then?
It's sarcasm. I'm just trying to get across how angry I am at not being allowed to use the lavatory for the last 15 days.
Why don't you just say you're very angry at not being allowed to use the lavatory for 15 days?
Because I am a polite, well-brought-up, English, middle-class person. That's why. The stench of the ordinary's around here. Gosh! People like me are nailed to the cross of civilization and forced to pretend to be nice, even when confronted by amoeba-brained byproducts of animal baggery like you.
Well, that's not a very nice thing to say.
Oh, feeling intellectually challenged, are we? What are you gonna do? Resort to violence?
Leave it to me. I have experience in this field. That's a very good and surprisingly popular idea.
Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no. I'm just being intellectual. Imagine I'm Tony Blair.
Get this, Tony!
Weird!
Ha! Fucking ha!
Feeling sore?
I am.
I am incredible. The things I can think of to say.
Richie?
Yeah? Hey, shut up. It is me. No sudden movements. No loud noises. I think I'm about to blow.
What?
Shut the fuck up.
What?
Eddie, I haven't had a shit since last Friday week. That reminds me, Eddie. The kitchen sink. Eddie, have you got a plunger?
Certainly have. That's what all the ladies say.
Have you got a woman in here? A woman in here? That's against house rules. We agreed. You're not allowed any women in here unless you get one from me at the same time. One who really do it. Like in my favourite video, Noddy goes lap dancing. It's my auntie that pays the rent. An agreement was reached. Fuck, Eddie, this is serious. Where is the toilet?
Ah, yes, I've been meaning to talk to you about that.
I'll talk about it now. Say things like, it's over there. Here's a lot of bog roll.
It's out of order.
Don't kid me about Eddie. I'm sitting on top of a human Hiroshima. Where is the lavatory?
The lavatory is no more.
What? What? Well, what have you been using?
I have been using the evacuator.
The evacuator?
The Storm Force Plus 5 Industrial Grade Evacuator Mark 3, to give it its full title. It's not strictly for lavatorial use, but... ooh, it does the job.
What does it actually do?
Well, this little baby works on the same principles as a Hoover.
Huh.
Except that this one can clean your whole house in 30 seconds flat simply by removing the entire contents. Everything. Unsightly household stains, walls, carpets. It's all conveniently removed and converted into black matter.
All right! Top-notch creativity! Let's give it a whirl.
Right. Take your trousers down.
Fucking, I'm not going to take my trousers off in front of you.
Well, would you like to use the modesty screen?
Crikey, a modesty screen. God, Eddie, this is so 21st century, isn't it?
Oh, Right? And pants down.
Pants coming down. Anything is possible with the new modesty screen.
You can tell we're in Essex, can't you?
We are so contemporary, aren't we?
Right, now if you'd like to turn and bend slightly.
Bend slightly.
And...
Oh, lummy. Oh, gosh, that is refreshing. Oh, my, that is keen. Eddie, I think you may have trapped a bit of my skin down there.
No, those were your testicles.
Oh, so they were. I thought it was hurting like fuck. So, what does the evacuator actually do?
Well, it does exactly what it says on the tin. It fucks your house completely.
Well, if that doesn't work, nothing will. Through the switch.
Righto.
Oh, this is good.
My God, this is good.
Oh, it's suddenly very thorough.
Ow! Eddie, log jam.
Some bastard must have slipped me some Imodium last week.
I'll increase the power.
Switch it off! I think it's got a hold of my kidneys!
I can't seem to switch it off, Rich. The on-off switch appears to be broken.
Well, you've got to do something, Eddie. I can feel my lungs being pulled out from my rectum.
Well, I've got to do something anyway, Rich. The needle has gone way past dangerously too full and is creeping up towards close your eyes and run like fuck. Hey. Hey. Who would have thought you could be so full of shit? There's nothing for it, Rich. I'm going to have to stick her into reverse.
What?
Get ready to receive. Incoming.
Oh, God. Lummy.
There. That seems to have done it. Now I'll just remove the pipe and... Now, you might be feeling some discomfort because, well, I emptied next door's house this morning.
Yes.
So you've probably got their sofa up there.
What? What? Eddie! Eddie, what are you telling me? You have just shoved our next door neighbour's sofa up my ass.
Well, look on the bright side, Richie.
What exactly is the bright side to having your next door neighbour's sofa shoved up your ass?
You can sit down while you're standing up.
True. Good work. Eddie, is it me?
Yes.
Eddie, is it me?
Yes, it is.
Bad, Eddie. Is it me, or is it something to do with having my arse filled with unsolicited furniture? But you seem to have turned the lavatory into some kind of laboratory.
Yes. I call it my lavora bora lavora bora ora tora 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 tori.
Wow! The lavora ora tora tora bori bop.
The lavora
Sorry.
Fucking close.
Billy, please explain.
Well, it was after a particularly arduous night at the Lamb and Flag, followed by the obligatory 8 hours kicking in the police cell, when I came to, and I thought to myself, Richie, you've got your name wrong. Your name is Eddie. You are still pissed. You're pissed, aren't you? I said to myself. No, I'm not, I said back. No, yes, you are. Do you want some? Yes, I said. So I gave myself some. And it was just as I landed a spectacular doozy of a haymaker on my own jaw that I thought to myself, Eddie! Thankfully getting my fucking name right. I thought, Eddie, what are you doing? You're throwing your life away on drink, booze, and lager. So I decided it was time to do something with my life, to make my mark. I came back here determined to invent something that would stand forever as a shining beacon of human endeavour. Oh. Now, 10 minutes in this toilet, this very toilet, and I had done it. And then I started work. Feverishly. Like a man drunk on alcohol, which I was. I crashed about the bathroom, accidentally knocking various industrial strength cleaners and the contents of the medical cabinet into the bath. I fell in, face first, and the mixture, heated only by my own malty breath and flatulence, fermented. And when I awoke, I discovered that I had invented the answer to all of mankind's problems.
The answer to all of mankind's problems? Eddie, what in heaven's name is it?
Weapons-grade lager. Oh.
Weapons-grade lager.
Crikey. Sounds like a pretty stiff tipple.
What's it like?
I can't remember. Every time I take a sip, I get completely pissed.
Just one sip and you get completely pissed?
Yeah, and there's no hangover. It is a drinking breakthrough.
You mean there's none of that awful morning after feeling?
There is no morning after. In fact, there's no day after. One sip and you go straight into a coma for the next 24 hours. You wake up at exactly the same time the next day, ready to start drinking again. It is a self-perpetuating drinker's paradise.
But Eddie, this is marvellous. This could be the defining moment in British economic history. Eddie, we could set up a company and start to make proper money, like all the other ghastly middle-class twats do. Only better.
Yes.
This has got legs.
Hey, Richie, I've got legs too.
Well, I've 8 legs.
Wow.
Then all we need to do is some marketing.
Oh, what is marketing, do you know?
Well, it's just a load of old bollocks, isn't it?
Hey, I've got a load of old bollocks.
Well, that's the marketing sorted then.
Weapons-free lager. A self-perpetuating drink of paradise.
Eddie? Small point. For the strongest drink ever brewed, a sort of hard man blitzkrieg liver rupturing death juice, why have you called it GMTV?
Because it completely fucks your mind.
And that's desirable, is it? Oh, Eddie, why are you an alcoholic?
Because I drink a lot. That is the word for people that drink a lot. And it's not easy being an alcoholic, you know. It takes commitment. It's not just a hobby. It's not just for Christmas. It's a way of life. This land is littered with failed alcoholics.
Well, not this one, boy.
I'm a stayer.
Oh, Eddie. Can't you see it's not doing you any good? Look at you. What's happening? We used to be friends. Good friends. But this drinking, it's... Oh. This drinking, it's... Oh. Can't you see what's happening to us?
Ah, don't push me too far, Richie. Get off of my case. Cut me some slack, why don't you?
Christ, it's just yadda, yadda, yadda all day long.
Oh, ease up, why can't you? I'm like, I can't believe, like, are you for real? I'm like, wake up and taste the coffee, guy. Two sugars for me, please.
Oh, that is just so last week. Are you happy now? I am up to here with you.
Well, I am up to here with you.
Well, maybe we're the same height then.
Whoa, don't go there.
Oh,
I am there. Oh,
like
whenever. Not
like hello.
Like Eddie, what the fuck are we talking about? I can't understand a single word that I'm saying.
Well, that's marketing for you.
Is it? Because there you go. Our company is really motoring. What other products have we got? What else have you invented?
The patent painless tattoo remover.
The patent painless tattoo remover.
Now, Rich, don't you have a tattoo?
Yeah.
On your penis? Isn't it Ethel Cardew's name and phone number?
It has elements of Ethel Cardew's name and telephone number.
What do you mean?
Well, there was only room for two letters. And they spelt no. Thanks to the talents of that dyslexic tattoo artist.
Oh! I thought you tried to write knob on your penis. Just so you could remember what it was. It being so small and hardly used. Didn't you take him to court?
Yes! Absolutely did. His lawyer said there was no evidence. Yes, there bloody well is. It's down there, hidden behind my pube. He said it would never stand up in court. I said, yes, there bloody well. I started masturbating like a dervish in the witness box. Thinking the first decent hard-on I'd had in 9 years. But there was a sudden rush of blood for the evidence. I fainted. Woke up in police station. 6 months they gave me for what they call gross indecency. Just for leaping around the courtroom, waggling my knob in the judge's face. It was his own fault anyway, for looking so beguiling in that wig.
Richie, this tattoo, is it unsightly? Embarrassing? Cramping your style? Why not get rid of it with Eddie's patent painless tattoo remover?
Jazz.
No, Richie.
Bada, ba, bada, bada, ba, shoo.
That's jazz.
You're right, Eddie. I'm sorry. I mean, that's a good idea.
Indeed it is. So if you'd just like to stick the tattooed area onto the operating plinth.
You want me to put my penis through this hole?
That's right.
Won't anyone see?
No.
How come?
It's too small.
Oh, yes. Brainy idea.
So get it out.
It is out.
Is it?
Yeah, that's it. Just down there.
What, that's it? That's what all the fuss is about. Hello, little fella. Yeah, I see what you mean. It's sort of regularly formed in terms of shape and proportion. Oh. It's just logic dictates it should belong to a 6-inch high man.
a rather well-endowed sixth inch hammer.
That's right, Rich. You've got nothing to worry about apart from the tattoo and your height.
Yes, well, I have always gone for the shorter bird myself.
I'm sure Barbie would be very pleased to see you.
How do you know these things? I gave her a good rinse out and screwed her leg back on.
Right. It's going to reconfigure the laser, energise the energizer, and isolate the target zone.
My word, that is all sounds very technical.
Your safety is paramount.
Oh, that's very reassuring.
Although you might feel a slight tingle. And bingo!
Bingo? Is that a medical term?
It is round here, matey. Whoa.
May I just say, fucking ow!
We're getting that response from a lot of our patients.
Well, is the tattoo gone?
Oh, no, it doesn't remove the tattoo.
It doesn't?
No, it just makes it more illegible.
What, the tattoo or the penis?
Ooh, both.
Eddie. Eddie, I know you think I'm full of shit. Well, now, of course, I am. But, in my experience, when a man has his arse filled with unsolicited furniture and his penis blattered into a sad flat marshmallow, that is the time when acts of sudden life-threatening violence seem to be the only option.
What is it you're trying to say?
This. Bloody right! Fuck! What are you there for? Oh, I think I've hurt myself.
Well, how did you do that?
Sorry, correction. I think you have hurt myself.
Well, how did I do that?
We've been having a fight for the last 5 minutes.
Have we? Oh, blimey. Doesn't time fly when you're having fun?
Not as much as my bollocks do when you keep kicking them underneath my new sofa. Oh, God. Hey, Eddie. What's this trunk? P. Richards. And whose trunk is this?
It's mine. It used to belong to my old uncle.
Your uncle? I thought you didn't have any relatives. Apart from that orangutan.
That was thrown out of court.
Yeah, but he climbed back in again. And anyway, how come your uncle has my surname?
He was very bad at spelling.
Ah, runs in the family.
That's dysentery for you. It affects the spelling.
But wait a minute. How come your uncle lived at my Auntie Marjorie's address? And look, there's my great-uncle, Lance Corporal Peregrine Richards. Look! And look, there's the Richard family, family arms. Oh, it's very impressive.
It's a dying swan with large breasts
being trampled to death by a unicorn with enormous bollocks. A roguish grin on his face. Oh my, look! There's my Auntie Marjorie! And look! There's my old Teddy! Eddie! Who was your uncle? Are we related? Perchance we are brothers! Eddie, I'm sure I somehow recall running naked down the sands at Hove, being beaten senseless by my Uncle Sigismund with his belt. I'm sure there was another naked boy there. Was it you? Come here, dear brother. Embrace me.
No, 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 no. I am not your brother. Oh, all right, I admit it. I've got no uncle. It was your uncle. The trunk was sent to you.
Eddie, please explain.
Bad news. It's about your late uncle, Richie.
Uncle Richie? I didn't know I had an Uncle Richie.
No, it's about your late Uncle Richie.
He's late? What time is he supposed to be here?
Now, look, just shut up and sit down. I've got some very bad news for you.
Right. What's the bad news?
There's no chair there.
No, that's okay. I've got a sofa up my arse.
The trunk was sent to you.
But when?
15 days ago.
15 days ago? Eddie, very coincidental.
It was exactly 15 days ago when you locked yourself in the lavatory.
Yes. There's almost a plot this year. Keep your fucking eyes peeled, though. Yes, the two incidents are related.
Related? What can this mean? Am I related to the trunk? Is the toilet my auntie?
No, it means your great-uncle Peregrine is no more.
No more what?
He's dead.
He's no more dead! How can this be?
Get a grip. Look, your great-uncle Peregrine is dead of not living anymore.
Oh! Oh, hold me firm, Earth!
Oh, fuck it, he's acting. Wake me up when he's finished.
What thunderbolt of happenstance is this? I mean, alack the day, cry for shame. Howl ye winds, snap ye twigs. Great Uncle Peregrine, gone. Did he leave me any money?
No.
No?
No, not a sausage.
Damn! Wretched skin-thin bastard! Why have you died painfully? Have you died writhing in agonising pain? All on your own, in some hovel, somewhere disgusting, like Basildon.
Cheap, crowd-pleasing tart.
You! Expensive, crowd-disappointing piece of cake.
Why don't you own up to the fact that you were actually born in Basildon?
That True. Is just outrageous. That's beyond outrageous. I was born here. This is my town. I am a local, I love Southport! This is my town! Eddie!
Yes.
You know, mate to mate. What's the next line?
Why don't you look in the trunk and see if you can find the plot in there?
Right. Okay, mate, thanks. Turn the cameras off then. It's a DVD. Oh, Eddie, look!
Oh, the plot.
It's the fucking plot.
Look!
It's my great-great-uncle Willenthrop's First World War uniform. Look, there's the bullet holes where he was shot at the court-martial.
That's when they found out he was a German.
That he was trying to join the Germans. Hey, what's this? It's his will. It is! Look! Ugh, blah, 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 blah. Some legal drivel. No cash there. Shit. Hey, what's this? Something about some inventions. Weapons-grade lager. Patent painless tattoo remover.
Yeah.
Evan.
Yeah.
I think you beat my uncle to it there. You've already invented them. Who was this? P.S. You must share it all with Eddie. It's written in some kind of barely intelligible childish hieroglyph. It reminds me of your handwriting, Eddie.
Yes. I think he had that disease that makes your handwriting look a little bit like mine.
It is remarkably like yours, Eddie.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he must have had it bad.
No, it can't be yours, Eddie. Look, it says here at the bottom, this is not Ebby's handwriting. So there you are. Hey, look, Eddie, there's a panel at the bottom.
What?
What's this? What's in the panel? Look! Peregrine Richards, Elixir of Life! He who drinks of this sacred elixir shall live forever. He shall be immortal. 2 level teaspoonfuls to be taken between meals.
Fuck that. Come on, lift through the whole bottle. We can be immortal.
Well, I fucking will. I've just had the whole lot.
Fuck you, you mortal. I'm going to live forever.
Hey, Reg, this must be Great Uncle Peregrine's scientific journal.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Look. 10 minutes have passed since I partook of the elixir of life. Feeling groggy. Oh, God, no. All seems to fade. Darkness comes. And anal leakage.
I don't remember him being that ill last night.
He seems to be communicating from beyond the grave.
Yeah.
Yes, look, the pen moves, yea, verily, as I watch. Oh, shit, my bollocks have exploded. Hope fades. This is the...
What?
That's it. There is no more. The pen seems to have just slid off the page.
Oh, God. Couldn't even write a decent poem.
No, Rich. He died.
I know. That's why we got his trunk. He fucked up with the elixir and it killed him. Oh, shit! What have I done? Eddie, I'm going to die in 10 minutes.
9 now.
9 minutes?
Well, less than that now.
Eddie, what am I going to do?
Well, I don't know what you're going to do, but I'm going to sit and watch. Do you mind if I videotape it for my friends? They like a good laugh.
What about my friends?
You haven't got any.
Oh, yeah. Good. So I don't have to waste any time saying goodbye to them. Eddie, how long is it now?
About 7 minutes.
7 minutes! God, I haven't even started on my deathbed monologue yet. I need something moving to put on my gravestone.
A slug?
Oh, why did I drink it? It just seems so tempting. I mean, to live forever. I mean, Rahade Bhagare. I mean, if I was to live for all time, I'd be bound to get a bird in the end. But now, I'll never get a shag. Back in the hill to room 303. Oh, Eddie. If only Uncle Peregrine had invented something useful, like a time machine, I could turn back the clock and not drink the wretched stuff.
A time machine, you say?
Oh, don't trouble that sad pile of dog shit lodged in your skull that you vainly claim to be a brain. There's no way you can invent a time machine. Hey, Eddie, what's this? I thought you said the toilet was no more. Christ, thank God for that. I thought I was never going to get rid of this sofa. Trouble that sad pile of dog shit lodged in your skull that you vainly claim to be a brain. There's no way you can invent a time machine. Hey, Eddie, what's this? I thought you said the toilet was no more. Christ, thank God for that. I thought I was never going to get rid of this sofa. Eddie, something really fucking weird is going on.
Yes, Rich, you have discovered my little secret.
What secret?
I have invented a time machine.
But it looks like a toilet.
Yes, it is my masterpiece. A time-travelling toilet. I call it the TARDIS. Every time that you pull the chain, you are transported back in time to a predetermined point.
Pull the chain?
No, 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 don't pull the chain.
Okay. Oh, Eddie, don't trouble that sad pile of dog shit lodged in your skull that you vainly claim to be a brain. There's no way you can invent a time machine. Hey, Eddie, what's this? I thought...
Sorry.
I thought you said the toilet was no more. Christ, thank God for that. I thought I was never going to get rid of this sofa.
Clarity, do not pull the chain.
I am desperate for a shit.
You've just had two in the last 45 seconds. Right, now listen up, Rich. This is very, very complicated. Right, you're trapped in a time loop. I'm going to have to take you back in time, about half an hour or so, and then fast forward you to the present, so we can get a good run up to the moment where we want to change the history of time, stop you drinking the elixir, and save your life. Although, you might die in the process.
Just go for it, Eddie.
Okay, and pull the chain. I got a cold, herpes, and I lost my fucking wallet. Answer me this. Do all birds in Southend have beards? Now, Rich, you are now frozen in time at that point at which you fatally partook of the elixir. You cannot move.
Oh, great.
Nor can you speak. But I know you can hear me. Wanker. Sweaty wanker. You sweaty, overweight, has-been wanker. You are now frozen at that moment in time, and I have to introduce a new element into the logic of time. What shall it be? A violent element, perhaps? Yes. Now, what shall I hit him with? Perchance the scaff bar? Or shall I twat him with the sports sock full of billiard balls? Or that old favourite, the old anvil on a rope? Nay, I hear ye cry, when in Southend, do as the Southendingonians do. Yes, I shall twat him in the mush with my mighty cricket bat. Oh, joyous sound of nasal cartilage on willow. The mighty thwack of his jawbone dispatched with consummate ease through the French windows of the pavilion. It's tea before lunch with your bales in your pocket, your googlies round your neck and a fucking good booze up all round. Up stumps and have a chimmy hearties. Four.
What?
Sorry, six.
Good shot, Eddie. You saved my life!
Have I? Oh, shit.
I live! See how I live! See me
caper. See me gamble. See me scamper about the place with abandon. See me kiss Eddie with delight.
See me look slightly nervous.
See me shower Eddie with love.
See me cock my cricket bat and turn slightly psychopathic.
See me retire gracefully and stop saying see me type things.
See me say shut the fuck up, you sweaty has-been wanker. And get ready for a right royal scene too.
See me try to get a quick one in first. And fail. Twice.
See me say ha-ha. Didn't expect that one, did you?
See me say...
Oh, you didn't fucking expect that one, did you? Right. In the fucking bullets. That's right. But see me say... Ha-ha! I fucking did actually, Dirty Den. And that is why I used my Tai Chi Kwando techniques to transform my testicles into balls of steel.
What? Ow, Jesus! You bastard! That's my wanking hand!
Wanking finger.
Ah, wanking fingernail. Anyway, damn you, you slanty-eyed oriental fiend.
See me say, prepare for blood-curdling, holly-flying, violent clasplation with cricket blood.
See me say, bloody hell, Benny Hill, I thought you were dead.
See me say,
never mind about all this see me, this see me, that bollocks. Eddie, look what we've got. A time machine, a real live time machine that actually works.
See me saying, I was rather enjoying all that see me this, see me that bollocks.
See me say, will you just shut the fuck up, you talking dildo? And miming, you sad dildo. Eddie, look. Why, with this machine... Eddie, with this machine, we have the fate of humanity in our grasp. Why, with this machine, we can alter the very fabric of the universe.
You don't mean...
Yes! We can get to the bar before the audience!
Let's go for it! Resetting coordinates to theatre bar, 2 seconds from now, maximum power. And throw the switch.
I can't, it's attached to the wall.
OK, pull the chain.
My head on the door.
I can't.
Why not?
I'm enjoying myself too much.
Ow! Eddie, I think you may need to insert a pause into your merrymaking for a moment.
But I haven't had this much fun since you accidentally trapped the tip of your penis in the electric can opener.
Never mind about all that now. Eddie, you have just landed the TARDIS in the wrong place. Again, this is not the bar either.
What? Blah. Let's have a look. No pools of vomit, no broken teeth, no dismembered limbs. You're right, this is not the bar of the Cliffs Pavilion.
Eddie!
Who said that?
Eddie!
Yeah?
It's me down here.
Hey, Rich! I think I found a local. got that typical South End breath. Where's the bar, you bastard?
Ow! Eddie, that is not illegal. That happens to be my arse.
Well, would you mind asking your arse where the bar is?
Eddie, my arse does not have intimate knowledge of all the bars in South End.
It's not what I've heard. Tinkerbell.
What do you know? Anyway, it's not Tinkerbell. It's Tinker Bollocks, actually. Oh, look, Eddie, be a mate. Would you be a mate and pull my head out?
I beg your pardon?
Now, Eddie, go on. I've never been stuck in such a tight hole in all my life. Eddie, I simply cannot pull myself off. No, look. Oh, Eddie, if you could just lubricate around my head and give me a really good, hard yank, then I'd be able to come off. I mean, come out. Oh, God, I seem to be stuck in some kind of gay double entendre nightmare.
Right, here we go. Now, you might feel a slight twinge.
That is snug.
It's just a stick of dynamite.
All right. It's what?
Yeah, just lighting the fuse. Here we go. There.
Eddie, let me get this straight. You've just stuck a stick of dynamite up my asshole and lit the fuse.
That's right. You got the picture.
But Eddie, isn't all this a bit dangerous?
You're right. I shall move to a safe distance away.
Eddie! Eddie!
Oh, Eddie. I think it's gone out.
Well, did it work?
Well, the fucker went off. Now listen, Eddie. I think you misunderstood the physics of the situation.
Huh?
The stick of dynamite stuck on my asshole seems to have jammed my head even further into the door hole.
Door hole.
What is required is some sort of force applied from the opposite direction.
Gotcha. Yeah. Right. This little baby should do the trick. Here we go. I beg your pardon?
I said...
I thought so. Oh, what is it now?
Also, Eddie, isn't this the most ridiculously dangerous thing one could possibly do?
You're right, but... with your head pointing that way, I shall be perfectly safe. And my face won't end up looking like your arse. So, in with the dynamite, light the fuse, and run like fuck.
Eddie, come here.
Come bloody here. I am going to swear at you.
So sexy. Don't. I'm going to swear at you. I'm jolly angry.
Eddie, you burk. You flipping nuisance. You stupid effing bugger. You bloody buggering bastard breast-faced bollock. You arsing knob-head tit-faced fucking twat.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry? Good. Apology accepted. Grudgingly. Now, Eddie, where the fuck are we?
We've got absolutely no idea. That is why you're so cross.
I know that, you twat. You twat-shaped twat. You twat-nosed, foreskin-breast arse-wipe.
You're repeating yourself, Rich.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No,
oh, yes, you
are. No, I'm not. I didn't say foreskin before.
You're right. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Apology accepted again.
Oh, you've got a lot of anger in you, haven't you?
Yes, I bloody bloody have. It's all in here.
Yeah? Where?
This bit right here.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel your pain. Oh, boy. Oh, that is a lot of pain. Whoa. Oh, that is a very angry pain, isn't it? Oh, Christ, you're so fucking angry, you could kill someone like this.
Yeah. Oh, God, oh, no, just... Oh, God, quad bike flashback.
Oh, God. It's just like the last time, except this time, Eddie isn't standing there with a brake cable in one hand and some scissors in the other. Eddie, look, it's not that kind of anger that I'm talking about.
No?
This is the kind of anger I'm talking about.
Oh, I see! Oh, I see that kind of anger! It's much more sort of personal. Not so much in your face as in your bollocks kind of anger.
That's the one, you've got it, Eddie.
Righty dokey. Understood. Me old ready, steady, oven ready, chuck steak, skip jack, dippy finger licking, foul tasting, arse basting, vomiting a basing spud you don't like. Oh, yes. I am the white M&M. What is it you're so angry about, motherfucker?
Well, bloody hell, Mr. Eminem, I'll bloody well tell you what's the matter with me. I'll bloody well tell you, you granny fucker. No, Eddie, I'm not going to stand here being working class. It's just ridiculous. Look, I'm not going to stand here and simply say I am better than you. Of course I am, but I'm not going to say it. People of my status simply don't. But, Eddie, we have been travelling in that ugly time-travelling TARDIS, looking for the bar now for 3.5 years, and I am fucking thirsty!
Well, shall we give it another go?
No, please, look, Eddie, look. Let's just think, shall we? We'll think this time before we press any buttons.
Oh, shit.
Now, look, where were we when we originally put in the coordinates?
No, a fucking horrible theatre in Southend.
Oh, don't talk about those people, Eddie. God, I mean, never washed the stench out of my clothes.
Look on the bright side, Rich. With any luck, this time we might get back to a South End where you can travel down the London Road at faster than 2 miles an hour.
Yes! I'll tell you what, we could go back in fucking time and get back to the South End before they built that fucking lakeside shopping centre. Why don't they just call it Broadmoor? Have you seen the people in there?
Bullocks. Hey, I fucking like Basildon.
I mean, oh.
3 fucking hours. 3 fucking hours I was this morning on the Saddler's Farm mini fucking roundabout. 3 fucking hours and I wasn't even in a car. Let's get back to the bar before he gets clogged up with all those Essex types. You know how those fuckers can drink.
Just don't talk about them, Eddie. God, they'll probably put us in quarantine when we get back to London.
And pull the chain! What?
It worked! Eddie, your fantastic TARDIS worked the very first time!
Right. The That'll be 17 pints of lager.
And a small sherry, please, barmaid. What a marvellous pair of breasts you've got.
It's a frightfully amusing play because he said wanker and then he said wanker and then that one capped it all by saying wanker.
But it's so ironic.
It's Oscar Wilde.
No, it's so ironic because there's 1,500 people here who want to kick their teeth in.
Let's move on.
God, yeah, a pub crawl. God, yes. Yeah, pub crawl. God, I'm so hardcore. Come on, let's put on our hats backwards and talk about pop music.
And pull the chain.
I'm not afraid to swear. I'll bloody well do it. This is just too bloody shit and spooky. Eddie!
Yeah?
What the fuck happened there?
No, it's just
what
stop.
Is going
stop.
On?
Stop, stop. You did that speech 2 years ago.
Did I?
Yeah.
How was I? Be honest.
Crap by the sound of it.
Yeah, but how was I just then?
Oh, stupendously crapper.
Wait a minute, this here now is 2 years ago. Listen, Eddie, if we go even further back in time, we could do some really old material. Just think, I might be able to get erections again. No, no, it'd be nice. It won't hurt. Oh, God, I know. This is great. No, shut up. Watch this. Here we go, this is bloody great. Oh, it's very good. Here we go. Shut the fuck up! I'm serious! Shut up, this is brilliant, I can do this. Shut up. Shut up! I'm really great and brilliant, Vivian! You haven't changed your material very much, really, have you, Eddie?
Stick with what works, that's my motto. That is why I have been wearing the same underpants for the last 27 years.
Really?
Come on, it's my round.
Oh, God, all right.
And pull the chain. We've now worn the batteries down, so we're stuck here forever.
What?
Do not despair.
Why not? There's fuck all else to do.
Because I have had an idea.
Oh, really? But another one is due.
It's 2 years since you had the last one. Hey, let's go to the pub, you said.
Oh, shit, that's my idea this time.
Oh, Mary, mother of Jesus, his penis.
Or we could reverse the polarity on the motherboard and connect it up to the hyperdrive via the space-time continuum clutch deregulator and hey presto.
Hey presto what? A dictionary of meaningless words?
No, a friction-driven battery charger.
Friction?
That's right.
What an interesting concept. Tell me, Eddie, how will this friction be supplied?
In a highly pleasurable way. By extreme rhythmic movement.
I am intrigued. Pray continue.
I should point out that the machine could be highly unstable, and that to volunteer to drive it could be an act of almost suicidal heroism. But extraordinary self-gratification.
Extraordinary self-gratification, you say?
I do.
Eddie, I feel a noble task beckoning. You know, there comes a time in every man's life when he stands on the horizon of his destiny and he has to ask himself one question. I wonder if Eddie's got any dirty mags. Have you got any sort of glamour publications, Eddie? Sort of Kylie Minogue fitness video, perhaps. Or a Grattan's catalogue. Or Eddie, perhaps you've got a Kirsty Young publicity photo. It's fantastic. She's sitting on the corner of her desk. You can't actually see that corner. You can see the rest of the desk, but you can't see that corner. And Kirsty's pressing against... And she's smiling. That's very important. She's smiling very broadly. Kirsty Young has got a secret. And I know what it is. But she doesn't know that I know.
And she will probably never find out, will she? Because of the exclusion order.
No, nothing was ever proved.
They found the windscreen wipers from her car in your wife runs.
I was cleaning her windscreen with my knob for charity.
Ah, Richie, here are some magazines that I accidentally prepared earlier for you. Now, we have a choice of reading material. We have knicker-busting amateur pensioners.
God.
Oh, God.
Bloody hell. Hey, Eddie, my knob's gone all numb. It's got a lot bigger, though. Oh, shit! Oh, no! It was him!
Yes. I'm beginning to understand why Stephen Fry left that play.
How strange. Your pocket seems to have the odour of Stephen Fry.
So you know what he smells like, then? Have you had enough, or do you want some more?
Oh, fuck.
Right. Amongst other reading material, we have pre-op readers' wives' accidents. Sumo donkey anal wrestling. And hot, hot, hot. Oh, no, that's just my welding magazine.
Looks all right to me. Look at the goggles on that. I'll take a look.
Now, unfortunately, there are some rigorous tests you have to go through before you can operate the machinery.
What? What Nazism is this, you bureaucratic arsewipe?
We just have to fill in the appropriate forms first. It's just some Stalinist bollocks before we continue. Imagine you are living in Blair's Britain.
Eddie, are you mad? I have in my possession the weapons of mass debation. In 45 seconds!
Yeah, but we just have to fill in some questions about your personal life first.
Questions about me? Oh, God! Questions about me! Oh, God, fantastic, fantastic! Shut up. Okay, okay, I'm not ready, I'm not ready. Questions about me. Oh. God. Okay, action.
Wait.
Wait! What are you implying? I live on Sweetex. I can still get into the same pair of jeans I wore when I was 17.
Only because you've sewn the living room curtains into the waistband.
I can still pass for 17.
Stones? Now wait!
No! I refuse to answer. This is outrage.
No! Wait there while I get another pen. This one is fucked.
I didn't do it! Do I look like a biro molester?
Have you seen my felt tip?
No, it, no, I've never seen your felt tip. I've only ever seen you naked once. I fell straight into a coma. I had to go to therapy for 6 years. Ever since I've seen you naked, I've always had to close my eyes when I walk past the butcher's window. I shall never eat tripe again.
Right, here we go. And wait. Oh.
Put, trim, alluring, snake-hipped. Just describe me as you see me.
All right, fat.
You can't put that.
You're right, very fat.
Oh, come on, Eddie. We've known each other for years.
Right. Very fat twat.
Let's just move on, shall we?
Right. Question two, why won't you tell me how fat you are?
It doesn't say that.
It does actually, look.
Oh, so it does. What a perceptive questionnaire. God, it's a bit curved, isn't it? OK, next question. Mm-hmm.
Why does everyone think you're a cunt?
God! They have really hit the nail on the head there, haven't they? Everyone think I'm a cunt. That's a question that's always intrigued me. I'll have to speak to my people and get back to you on that one, Eddie.
Huh?
Eddie, why do you think I'm a cunt?
Oh, boy, that is a big one. Oh, my, that is a doozy. My, my, I do declare. That is one rootin' tootin' dozy dozing string 'em up diddly squat tarnation shootin' my chootin' any young sidewinder strip down my dangler bits dang my skedaddlin' long johns john boy and blow the tail off a polecat knee high to a regular 10-gallon crawfish and that ain't no word of a lie, yes siree. Hooey!
Is that good or bad? Either way, I'm a pretty interesting guy, aren't I?
No, you're a cunt. Inside leg.
Inside leg, mostly flesh and bone.
Outside leg.
Trousers. Pretty fashionable ones as well.
Sex.
If only.
I'll just put fat. No, no, hang on. I'll put would like to meet fat bird.
No, no! Don't put fat. Put any. No, hang on. Put attractive, young, slim, professional, snake-hipped guy seeks any old slapper. Yeah, that should work. Into sub, dom, OA, Greek, French, not Welsh. No, not Welsh. You get so much lanolin on the sheets. It's far too messy. SM, pre-op, trans, group, strict, credit cards, all callers welcome, looking for affection, cuddles, naughty tickles, and colonic irrigation. Will that do?
That's a very thorough answer. It's a pity I wasn't listening. Now, religion.
Oh, at last! An intellectually challenging question.
I'll just put wanker. Seems to be all you do religiously. If you'd just like to sign here, please.
Oh, an autograph. How flattering. Whose name should I put? Sorry, force of habit. Whose name should I put, love?
Your own arse breath.
Arse breath. Eddie, this is just complete gibberish. This is just a meaningless, childish scrawl peppered with pornographic doodles.
That's right. Richard, this is your life.
emptied my soul out to you, and you've reduced my life to a meaningless scribble and a wildly inaccurate waist measurement. 178 feet! I demand a rewrite.
It's all right. No one's ever going to read it anyway. I was just wasting time, waiting for the dilithium crystal to reach optimum temperature, ready for the TARDIS to receive a sudden jolt of extraordinary power. Oh,
hey,
it's ready.
Is it? So am I. Come on, let's do it.
Right. Gee, here we go. Here are your magazines. And some screen wash.
Thank you. It is a far, far better thing that I do now. Oh, fuck the monologue. I'm going for a nasty.
Right. Now, Richie. Magazines open. Check. Trousers down.
Check.
Screen wash ready.
Check.
Penis!
You will go at my first whistle.
It is ready.
Check. Oh, no, sorry, that's my pube. Oh, no, I found it. Okay, check. Oh, right. Gosh, you better hurry up, Eddie. These magazines are awfully good. I might shoot without any friction at all.
Now then, ladies and gentlemen, now is the time for you to join in with our little drama. I know some of you have been itching to join in all night. You fucking twats. And some of you have just been itching, haven't you? I've spotted you. Is she your girlfriend? I'd chuck her. No, she's just, I've had her, she's rubbish. Now, this is the first organised mass heckle by every single member of the audience I think there's ever been in a theatre in Britain. I think you know the line. Some people have been giving it away all evening. Richie, give them their cue.
Eddie, I'm sitting all on my own in the toilet with a load of dirty mags in one hand and my knob in the other. What on earth should I do? I beg your pardon? I can't hear you. Say it again. Hey, that's a good idea. Okay. Oh, oh, blimey. Oh, Kirsty Young. Oh, Kirsty.
Oh, it doesn't usually last this long.
I feel awfully tired. I think I lost about 3 stone.
How was it for you, Rich?
Who said that? Eddie? Is that you? Eddie?
Hey, Rich! Rich, you've done a fantastic job. These batteries are 359,000% full.
Well, these magazines are awfully intriguing, Eddie. Do you know what? I think I'll give him another bloody good hard read in a minute or two when I got my breath back. Jesus! Eddie! Oh, Eddie! Eddie! I can't put these magazines down!
Yes, you said they were very interesting.
No, Eddie! I'm serious! Eddie, these magazines! Be a mate and pull me off!
Blimey, you've recovered quickly.
Magazines down, give me a good hard yank.
Richie, you're getting out of control. I'm gonna have to take those magazines away from you. Give me that.
Ow.
Give me that.
Oh.
All right, Rich. You should send a sample of your spunk to Araldite.
It,
It's technology like that that could put a man on Mars.
Yeah, but the fucker would have to stay there permanently.
Come on, we'll stick it in the shredder. That should get rid of it.
Oh, great. And now you've reintegrated it. How in God's name did you do it?
To tell you the absolute gospel truth, I've got no fucking idea. Every single invention I have made has been the result of sheer luck and mindless binge drinking.
But whatever it is, Eddie, thank God for it. You've just saved my girlfriend's life. Come, the pressure. Let's dance. Oh, Natasha, you are my love hound. You can go down my trousers anytime you like. I will give you as many tissues as you like to use. Draw my hand, lady. Hey, what's that?
Well, shit in my grandmother's mouth. Going backwards.
What?
We were at year zero. Now we're at year zero minus one.
No, no, minus two. Why?
You must have overloaded the circuits with your insanely overenthusiastic wrist action. We're at minus four now, minus eight, minus 13. Bloody hell. We are shooting back in time faster than Posh Spice slaps on the fake tan.
Bloody hell. That's fast.
We are hurtling back into pre-time. Richie, what's going on?
Eddie, we are going where no man has trod before. We are entering the night before the pre-dawn of all time.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, Richie. Something quite extraordinary is happening.
Yes, I'm quite well aware of that, thank you.
No, apart from this apocalyptic shift in time and space, my underpants are getting smaller.
What?
Some unknown force is controlling my underwear. My pants are getting smaller by the second. They're biting into my flesh.
Oh, God. Chris, Eddie, help me. This ain't my thing to do it. I'll have to get the panto obliterator.
Quickly, quickly.
Do not believe it. Look.
They're off.
Oh! Oh, the joy of the unconfined! In his wife friends have come off for the first time in 27 years!
That's why I'm asking.
Just shut the fuck up. This is my big monologue.
I'll pretend to look interested.
All right, convince me. Good. Oh, Eddie, look. We have arrived at the mother pants. These are the meaning. The meaning of everything is pants. These are the mother pants. Come, Southend. Let us take our pants off. To the mother pants, especially birds. It's very important religiously. Come, let us throw our pants in gifts of love for the pants. Let us all hit the button. Fuck. Hit the button again.
Because we are going to mess with your mind.
For free, what we are going to be doing. It's like doing all that finger stuff and like being young. I'm not going to say it. What we is going to do, we is going to mess about with your pants.
Come on, take your pants off. South End one.
I have been in South End all day, and the only twat I got near to was that one.
Right. Well, if you're not gonna get hold of your pants, we want you to all get hold of your coats.
Yeah.
Just get hold of your coats and fuck off.